The Overland Media Center opens up tremendous new opportunities to the New Life Evangelistic Center, opportunities in the field of renewable energy, the expansion of the administrative offices, even a dental clinic. We're going to look at that during this program. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Health. The Overland Media Center opens up tremendous opportunities to the New Life Evangelistic Center, opportunities for it to continue to expand its work at 1411 Locust Street in St. Louis, opportunities for adequate parking for its personnel at a time that we see barricades going up across the street on Locust and around 15th Street, around the meters and around the sidewalks, opportunities to relieve some of that parking pressure at 1411 Locust through the administrative offices being moved to 14. To here to Overland, as well as the Overland Media Center. There's many, many needs that are being faced at this particular time, and New Life Evangelistic Center trying to respond to those. But the opportunity of the Overland Media Center also provides opportunities for a renewable energy center at this particular facility, that and much more. So join us as we take a look inside here, the building at the new Overland Outreach Center. When we first enter the building, the first place we come to is the future bookstore, the Missouri Renewable Energy Bookstore. The New Life Evangelistic Center bookstore will be stocking this bookstore with all kinds of different books in the field of renewable energy, sustainable living, and it's an opportunity for individuals that come to the facility here to the renewable energy shows and also drop by to be able to get some of the best books out there. So it's just partly stocked at this time. We'll be stocking it further and all kinds of different bookshelves in here, and the potential is just phenomenal to continue to build one of the biggest sustainable living renewable energy outreach bookstores in the region. So we can try to help serve the community that way, so people can also begin to learn how to get off grid, to be energy independent. So we're excited about the bookstore that we have, and right behind the bookstore here, we also have the reception area and registration area that when folks first come to, say for an example, to an energy fair, they have the bookstore, and they also have the registration area. And then down here immediately to a left past a conference room, and again, keep in mind we're not ready to open up yet at all. This is just a sneak preview for you because there's still a lot of work being done. We have to actually get fire doors on each one of these different doors here, so 20 minute burn doors that for the protection as we we'll have in this building. And there's a lot of work that still remains. One of the things we're really thankful for is a nice elevator that we have in this building here, an elevator that we wished we had one like this at 1411 Locust, but it's just a blessing to have an elevator operational here in this particular building at this time. But I want to take you back over in here and just show you some of the stuff we've started doing back here. Every room is going to have a different type of renewable energy in it. It's going to feature a different type of renewable energy where people can just kind of walk around. We've just started this at this particular time and just have some of the different displays up. We still have a lot to do, a lot of work that needs to be done in this particular facility, but it's starting. We're starting to move forward on it, and a lot of work in this 20,000 square foot facility, but it's going to be quite an educational area once it's completed. So when people come to an energy fair here at the Overland facility, they will get quite an education. Every room will have a different form of renewable energy in it, all kinds of displays on the walls. People go from room to room. We'll have experts in these different areas and fields. They'll be in the room to answer questions, to have discussions. So the potential is phenomenal here as far as a year-round energy center and bookstore. So really excited about this. And again, we have quite a bit of work to be done, but there's been an awful lot of work that's already been done in this facility. When we first got it, there was problems as far as leakage on the roof, and the water would come, and it was almost like a swimming pool up there because it just continued to settle and then leak through. And so what we had to do is just totally put a whole new drainage system on the roof, get the roof totally fixed. That has been done. We just really thank God for that. And in addition to that, there's been all kinds of cleanup that's been taking place inside of this particular building. And again, as I indicate, we still have quite a few things that need to be done prior to getting it officially open. We have a preliminary occupancy permit which enables us to come in and do the necessary fix-up work, but we still need to go through and do some electrical work, plumbing work, a lot of, as I mentioned, the fireproof doors up on, all over here, so like a lot of those doors that need to be done. So there's still a lot to be done. Wayne will tell you more about that later, but just the potential of this particular facility here is just so exciting. We still need, and I'm asking you to please pray for this, 25 founder club members. These are individuals that would share $2,000, and we're going to put a big plaque up in the lobby where it first came through that will have the names of the founder club members on them. And these are people that have helped found this building. We thank God for those that have already become founder club members. We really praise God for that. But we still need to raise this additional $50,000 right away, and that's what we're asking you to please pray about being a founder club member. And if you can, and you feel God leading you to do that, then call right now. 314-881-3218. That's 881-3218. Become a member of the Founders Club because the potential is just so exciting in this facility.
Hi, I'm Wayne with New Life Evangelistic Center, working here over at Overland, Missouri Renewable Energy in Overland, Missouri. I've been doing a lot of work here, you know, replacing light bulbs, cleaning, wiping down walls, painting, priming, plugging holes in walls, and it's a major job. And we've got one main hurdle we need to cross here. We have all the plans and the floor plans and the mechanical plans, electric plans. What we're needing is we're needing volunteers and some contractors to come in to get some permits. To do a little bit of wiring. I'm qualified in heating and cooling, electrical. So basically, you're not coming in, you don't have to come in to do all the work, you need to come in just to make sure everything is upgraded to code and this and that. We have floor plans registered with the city. We have the mechanical. What we have is we need the electrical, we need the plumbing, and what we're asking for is volunteers for our heating and cooling system. I mean, it's just too overwhelming for me. You know, I'm the project manager and the building manager and maintenance supervisor, and it is overwhelming. But through contributions that the public has made, we've been able to fund a little bit of this, and we have to put doors. We have to put doors in. Every door in this building has to be replaced, and that's a major expense. So we're just asking the public, to get involved, with the prices of utilities and gas and electric and fuel and food, it's just outrageous. And we got to call it quits. We got to tell the government. We got to tell the people that own these companies, we've had enough. We're going to provide. We're going to make. We're going to renew. We're going to create our own. They've done it before, thousands of years before the 1900s, and when the big oil, when they struck oil, so we don't need them anymore. So we're asking for volunteers to come in and join and be a part of our Christian lifestyle and create programs for the public and training programs.
I'm talking to John Mango at this time, and John is on our board of directors here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And John, what do you think of this facility?
I think it has a lot of potential for the things that you are doing right now and the things that the community can benefit from.
Isn't it exciting? The whole building was donated to us?
Yeah, hey, praise the Lord. That's a good thing.
Amen. And now we're just having to raise the funds to do the necessary fix-up work. But areas that people can come through, they can learn renewable energy, as I indicated. We can move our business office over here. There's adequate parking that people can get involved. They want to volunteer. They can volunteer in the development department. Just so many different opportunities. So I'm excited. How about you?
Yeah, I'm very excited. And with the way that things are going and the look of the place as it is right now, mm-hmm. This is going to be something most exciting for everyone to deal with.
And folks can get directly involved. They can volunteer. What a blessing you could be at this hour by just getting involved, being a part of the historical outreach now that the Lord has opened up. We're going to continue our work, even doing more at 1411 Locust. But this gives us opportunities through the Overland Media Center here. We'll be able to bring our internet offices over here, mm-hmm. missions offices over here, our business offices over here, our development office over here. Yeah. So it's thrilling what God is doing.
Yeah, it's, and it's doors opening that we never thought of in the past. And so this is a great opportunity for everyone in the St. Louis area to even get involved in this project.
We're going to take a little tour of what we got open, not open yet, but what we've got set up for our Overland office to be open. We're going to come into renewable energy. We're going to start our tour in renewable energy, where we have solar off to the right. Over here we have ethanol, where you can make your own fuel for your cars.
Right.
And then we come back. We have what do we have in this office? This hasn't been set up. Here we have solar cooking and solar heating. Over here on this side we have say your power goes out, we have a generator. You hook up to your bicycle and you can hook up and you have a light. You know, you can hook it up if you're out for a day or a few hours. You charge up your battery, get your kids to charge your bicycle up and charge your battery, and you can watch the game. So we're going to come through here. This is all going to be renewable energy through here. You can see we are under construction, and this is a big building with a lot of rooms, and we need the funding to finish this out. But we have passive solar heating here, which is another training project. We really want to get a lot of training projects and get with the community, with the higher cost of energy and gas and electric. People are looking for alternatives because as the prices go up, our wages aren't going up.
Right.
So, we're all open. Here we have a little hydrogen. We're taking water and splitting the atom and getting nitrogen or hydrogen, and we're burning hydrogen in our cars. In here we have the dome homes. People can learn how to build their dome homes. We can have contractors in here, and their dome homes. I built a couple dome homes, and they are quite cheaper to make than your conventional homes, and they are a lot more stronger and energy efficient.
Well, before we go back to Wayne and he shows us a little more of the building, I want to talk to Pastor Scott. What do you think, Pastor?
Oh, I was just observing what a wonderful place. I mean, it's so many opportunities you can use. My first visit here was, I was thinking it was just maybe a little office building,
uh-huh.
but this building is quite substantial. There's so much potential, so I just love it, like that. So it really excites me, and I know you are excited, But I was just thinking how good God is, how He can He's doing these things, He's got something. He don't give you this for nothing. Mm-hmm. He said, you have this building because He got some work.
He's got
for
a
you
special
to do.
Thing.
That's right.
And it's like He's really moving us over there. I mean, all these circumstances, overcrowding at 1411 Locust, even the barricading of the parking meters, and the parking difficulties. And here we got two parking lots. I mean, just pray people catch the vision and become members, founder club members, okay? That they can become founder club members. Yeah. Over here, they have a present plaque that we want to replace this over here with a plaque with the names of our founder club members here, people who've helped us make that move and get in and become a part of what God is doing at this historical moment. I mean, we're just praying for 25 more founder club members where people will share $2,000 each. We praise God for those who already got. But this is an exciting hour, isn't it?
Yes, it is. I was in the basement, bought in the basement. It looks just as nice as the upper floors.
Yes,
so then there's a sub-basement, so there's just so much room and so many little office places and so many potential classrooms. It's just an astounding what God is doing, But I'm thankful, But, you've worked a long time, Reverend Rice, and God is not through with you yet.
Praise
God. So, He's still got things for you to do, I'm thankful for you, but I'm thankful for how God is working in our lives, because we just need people who are dedicated, So I'm thankful.
We thank God for all that He is doing. Let's go back to Wayne.
Here we have greenhouse, and it looks like in-ground in-ground homes where they'll have presentations. And in each room, we will have videos, brochures, and how-to packets available to the public to do it on their own. So let's come out of this area of renewable energy here. And I think this is where we stand on this part of renewable energy. I'm going to bring you out through here where we have wind turbine, and back through here we have ample restrooms. We really don't have to see the restrooms, but we have more renewable energy. Let's see what we have in here. We have geothermal, which is underground. You tap into the water, and the water cools, and the water heats. Since so far underground remains a constant, 55 degrees. So, you don't have to heat or cool too much more than, from 55 degrees.
Carl, as Wayne's been showing you, what God is doing here at the Overland Media Center, at the Renewable Energy Center, at the administrative office here, as a member of the Board of Directors of New Life Evangelistic Center, what thoughts go through your mind?
When believers pray, God creates and brings things into being. And as we pray and ask God for direction, He shows us what to do, and then He blesses what we do, and it grows. So the key is pray, use the word the way it's intended to be used, and then follow God's directions.
It's thrilling to see that the Lord gave us this building, and we've seen the roof work that's already been done, a lot of plumbing that's been done. They're going to be removing an abandoned house in the back this next week. The men have been doing a lot of work around cleaning up. They've still got fire doors we've got to put up, and a number of other things, but just what's already occurred, we just say thank you, Lord, don't we?
Yes, we do.
God is good.
As I said, as we pray and follow directions, actually the best thing to do is pray and ask God to fill in the blanks. Mm-hmm. What He comes up with is not necessarily what you'd come up with, but it will astound you.
We just praise God.
Yes.
Now let's go back to Wayne as he shows us more.
We have more rooms that are under construction. More rooms under construction, and it's all looking real good. More offices, drywall, all the doors have to be replaced. We're talking, we bought 10 doors as a sample, and that was $1,300. That's just the fireproof 20-minute doors. We also have, that's 80 fireproof 20-minute burn doors. They have to have a stamp on them from the fire protection. But we also have about 35 doors that are fire. They have to have electromagnets on them. They have to have stops on them. They have to burn for an hour and a half. We had 26 of them bid out at $15,000. So we have another 20 upstairs. That was just on the base layer. Okay, then we'll come around through here. We have another nice office here. We have waiting rooms over here, or however they want to use them. These can be exam rooms too, for the dentist. And then we're coming back through the nurse's station, and we have smaller waiting rooms. And with the light fixtures, we need to update the light fixtures. We threw a couple in just to have some lighting. They might want to change them, so why would we spend it all on the same light? This could be the doctor's main office right here. And then we come over here. We have a full potentially operating dental clinic. All the tools, all the x-ray machines, everything the doctor needs. He's ready to come in and set up and go. And we have another office just like this there. Same equipment. We have another x-ray machine in here. And then we have the automatic one that automatically goes around you right here. Okay, and then we come out through here. This could be another reception area if they choose to use the back parking lot.
I'm talking to Herb at this time. He's also on our board of directors. We're down in the basement. I mean, the building has tremendous potential.
Sure,
we can
does.
Fix this up. I mean, a lot of it. What do you think, Herb?
Well, when I was coming down the steps just now, I was thinking, man, this is bigger than what I thought it was. When you pull into the parking lot, you don't think it's that big.
Uh-huh.
But you said there's 20,000 square feet.
20,000 square feet just to be used for the glory of God, to directly help people and to just really offer people opportunities.
Right.
As I mentioned, the world of renewable energy, where our development offices can really grow, our administrative offices can grow, even the possibility in the future for a dental clinic is already set up back there for that. So this
is
so exciting.
I'm impressed. Well, I was told there's two more floors above.
There's still, you still got to go. Yeah, so Wayne.
I haven't saw them yet.
All right, well, Wayne's been showing them, and we'll have to get back to him and have him show us a little more. Okay.
But I was impressed at how big this basement is.
Yes.
I mean, my goodness, it is. It's, and it's solid, mm-hmm. you know. And there's been a lot of renovations going on, and I believe they are still ongoing.
They are, and that's why we need to get people involved, and we're asking people to continue to pray and be a part of the Overland Miracle.
Hi, I'm Jeff Schneider, volunteer with New Life Evangelistic Center here in Overland, Missouri. Just to talk a little bit more about the progress we've made. Wayne and I have been working diligently for the past few months, bringing in volunteers and getting plans together, finding parts. Wayne's been doing a lot of work over here. We'll talk to him in just a few minutes. But it's been a great great journey here at in Overland, a much-needed building for administrative our administrative staff to come over, as we're short of room at the Locust Street address. So coming here for administrative offices, much-needed space for all of our paid staff and some of our volunteers. So it's been an exciting journey. We're grateful. We've got the roof completed at this point. Which was quite a project, roof and the roof drains, to keep the water off the roof and keep everything dry and mold free. So a lot of exciting things going on.
If you can't afford to become a Founders Club member, then how about affording a door? Yes, how about a door? $150 where we can put a door in here. We have to get 90 of these doors at $150 each. So if you'd like to sponsor a door, maybe put a little tag on here that this door was sponsored by, and then the name of your family. But just let us know when you send in that $150 that you want to sponsor one of these doors. That it's a burn door where it stops the fire for like 20 minutes if fire was to take place. And it's required by law. And each of them have to have a special stamp on it. And we need to get 90 of these doors at $150 each. So would you like to sponsor a door for $150? If so, send your gift in to P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166, and say, I'd like to sponsor a fireproof door at Overland. I'd like to sponsor it, and here's my gift for $150. If you would just do that, and we find 90 other people to do it, that would take care of one of the big major expenses we have in this building at this time that's required by law.
This whole wall goes. This is going to be one giant room from that wall to this wall. They have, the fire marshal has what they call a path of egression. And what they want is a fully clothed fireman in his full suit to be able to carry a body over his shoulder to escape in a fire. So we have to have, you know, yeah, we have to have space. Plus, it doubles as a big meeting room. And this is all going to go all the way out to here, to right here. And then we have our staircase. Okay, let's go down to the elevator. I've got the elevator working, running fine. Basically, I've got the whole downstairs up to a minimal standard to where all we need to do is break through, get the doors, make sure the plumbing and electric floor plans are okayed by the plumber and the electrician in the city. And basically, we can get in the building, but all the doors have to be in place. See, they used to have a leak on the roof, and it leaked through, so, you know, floor has to be replaced. That's all been done. That's all been taken care of. And basically, with this wallpaper, I found it easier with these outside walls to strip the wallpaper, sand it down, prime it, and paint it. It leaves a wonderful, wonderful finish. This door here, this fire door here alone costs like $1,200, the one I have to put here.
I'm Jeff Schneider here with New Life Evangelistic Center and Missouri Renewable Energy, and part of the Overland Project, which I've been so very happy to serve on as a volunteer now. And just another part of the details of the project, we're having this house demolitioned. It was a residential home on our commercial lot here, so it needed to come down, and we're glad to take it down. It's quite old, and it needed too much work to fit into what we had here in our mission. Basically, what we're specifically here for is commercial activity and administrative reasons, so residential house isn't needed here on the property. So at this point, we've had all the asbestos taken out of it, and you'll see the windows are removed because they had asbestos on them, so they were carefully removed by
a professional asbestos company. Since that is completed now, by the end of next week, this whole building will come down. You'll see the piles of dirt here that we have will fill in the void so that we can then level off the grass. As you see back here, it will be level off with the surrounding area in order to provide a clean lawn. So by the end of next week, that'll be completely down and turned to grass in probably just a few weeks, and we'll be done with that. And of course, we'll continue to focus on our commercial administrative building as our main focus. We're so very grateful for this donation, and we plan on serving our community here in Overland and surrounding areas in an important way for our administrative staff. Can do so much here with all the room, the office buildings, and we'll be talking a little bit more about that here in the near future to keep you updated. So we appreciate all of you out there who are willing to donate your time and experience. Obviously, we still need volunteers, the skilled trades, as electricians. If you have a background as a licensed electrician or carpentry experience, some of these other things, we sure would appreciate if you give us a call at 314-421-3020, and we'd be glad to help guide you in the direction where the help we need here, and we'll keep you posted, keep the public posted. We thank you so much.
I'm with some of the Founder Club members. It's exciting. Why did you become a Founder Club member, Judith?
Well, I wanted to help out with this building. I saw the need.
Yes.
I knew it was going to be helpful to give you more room down in the on Locust Street for your homeless men. And I was looking forward to your opening your offices here, the clinic downstairs, and more room for the Larry Rice Ministries.
Well, this is exciting. You feel like you made a good investment by becoming a Founder Club
member? Oh, definitely, definitely. And I hope we can get more people to join in.
And Larry and Sarah, what about you? You feel you made a good investment becoming Founder Club members?
Definitely. I think that there's a real need for homeless in the St. Louis area that is not being realized.
Yeah.
Contrary to what is coming from the mayor's office. And I think this is going to be a marvelous contribution to working to solve that particular problem.
It'll give us more room at 1411 Locust to move the offices over here and to reach out in the area of renewable energy and the like. How do you feel?
I feel like it's a good thing. And I'm the person who actually came up with the idea. I saw you advertising on Channel 24, and God just said, you have it, you could do it. And it didn't look like at that point that I could. But he supplied some unexpected money at the end of the year.
That
we had lost for 6 months.
So you'd encourage other people to get involved and become Founder Club
members. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Founder Club members.
Yes.
Very much so. It's well worth the investment.
And we give people that opportunity, yes, to do make a big difference. A part of history is what they're doing.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I agree.
A part of history.
And if they don't have the money to be a Founder Club member, there are other needs here, like new doors, which you could donate for maybe $150 each, just to help put this building together.
What a blessing. And we thank God for each and every person that's getting involved. And this is an opportunity we offer you to become a member of the Founders Club. So please get involved, and please do it right now. And you can make out the check to New Life Evangelistic Center. Put a note, I want to be a Founder Club member for $2,000. Send it right on in. If you can't do the $2,000, then how about $150, like she mentioned, to sponsor one of the doors? What a blessing. And how I thank God for each one of you that are getting directly involved.